Let's talk about magnesium's effect on mood, especially anxiety and depression. There's a lot of things that magnesium does in the body. It's involved in probably actually more than 300 different enzymes involved in biochemical pathways. But I want to emphasize just one area, the effect of magnesium on neurotransmitters, which are hormone-like, but instead of traveling through the blood, they travel through the nervous system. Now, a magnesium deficiency is extremely common. Well over 50% of the population is deficient, and probably a lot more that have a subclinical deficiency. But it's very difficult to test magnesium since only 1% of your whole body's magnesium is in the blood. The rest is in the bone, it's in the teeth, it's in the muscle, and it's also inside the cell. So you kind of have to go by symptoms. And just take some magnesium, consume foods higher in magnesium, and see if these symptoms go away. So, if you're deficient in magnesium, you can get anxiety, depression, low tolerance to stress. You're not going to sleep that well. You're going to be irritable and brain fog. Other than that, you're going to be good to go. But magnesium has some direct effect on increasing serotonin. Serotonin is the hormone that kind of brings you in a state of well-being. It actually makes you feel calm, happy, and without stress. Number two, magnesium can decrease cortisol. So cortisol is a stress hormone, and if it's too high, it puts you in a state of stress. So many people have chronic elevations of cortisol and they're stressed out, and magnesium can help them. All right, number three, magnesium can lower adrenaline. Okay, so that's going to help your sleep. Number four, it can increase GABA, which is a neurotransmitter involved in relaxation and feeling calm and even sleep. Number five, magnesium can increase melatonin. It's going to help you sleep. All right, number six, it can increase the parasympathetic nervous system. What is that? That's the part of the nervous system that's responsible for rest and digestion. So it calms you down. It's actually an active wave in your body that's pushing things down to keep things calm. So let's say, for example, you ran up the stairs or you're exercising and then you stop. The parasympathetic kicks in there and brings your pulse rate down and calms you down. Without that, everything would stay fairly elevated for a long period of time. And in practice, I used to measure the parasympathetic nervous system. I had a test. It's called heart rate variability, which measures the autonomic nervous system. And when people would come in with very low parasympathetic function, if they were to exercise, their pulse rate would go high and it just would not come down. So they have to do very, very light things and not a lot of exercise. All right, number seven, magnesium decreases the sympathetic nervous system. So this is the opposing nervous system. This is the nervous system that keeps things turned on and it keeps you from sleeping. So magnesium can chill that out. And another name for the sympathetic nervous system is flight or fight. All right, there you have it. Magnesium's effects on your mood.
Before you go, if you have a question about a product, or you're new to keto and you want to know how to begin keto, or you're on keto and you need a debug because it's not going as smooth, I have a keto consultant standing by to help you. This is just for the people in the US. Hopefully, in the future, we'll be able to answer everyone's call. But I put the number down below so you can call and get some help.